This is something I've never had to do in a theatre before. I hope it doesn't get cancelled. I am in London. I haven't been to London in about a month, a whole month, to see a West End show. I've been starting to get the withdrawal shakes a little bit. So today, my lovelies, I am here in London to see And Juliet this afternoon, and then Frozen this evening. I am very excited. Frozen in particular has been a show that I've had cancelled on me about two or three times. I've had to move my tickets, and then I cancelled my ticket and decided to rebook. That was a whole drama. And I'm really intrigued about And Juliet, right, because I love jukebox musicals, but I tend to love the jukebox musicals that are more focused and have their story based around the band or the composer or the songwriter or artist that the songs are actually by. So like Jersey Boys, Sunny Afternoon, Beautiful, the Carole King musical, the musicals that normally have a bit of a bonkers story linked to the jukebox songs. I'm not usually as keen on those, but I've heard amazing things about And Juliet. And the fact is, it's lots of different songs by different artists. It's my kind of era, like 90s and early noughties, like pop music. I'm so going to be up for this. I'm pretty sure there's going to be visits to the merchandise stands at some point. I can't wait. I'm so excited. So better get going. See you there. Mwah. So, lovelies, I've just had a bonkers half hour going around Covent Garden, saw a skeleton singing Elvis, saw a guy nearly set himself on fire, and saw violins play Game of Thrones. That's just all in an all day here at Covent Garden. I also went into Benjamin Pollock's toy shop. It's a wonderful toy shop, guys, where I used to go a lot when I was a kid. But there's a lot of like theatrical stuff, and it's very beautiful, and I loved it when I was a kid. So whenever I come to London, I always try to support it. So I've just bought this book, Theatre Lore. It's sort of like a book of loads of theatre terminology. Okay, lovies, here I am. I'm at the Shaftesbury Theatre with And Juliet. There we go. I can't tell if it's backwards right now because I'm filming on my iPhone, so I forgot to bring my big camera. I'm on Shaftesbury Avenue, which is obviously a very noisy road. Okay, darling, so I'm here inside the Shaftesbury Theatre. Very, very exciting. And it's quite ironic, right, because the most recent video I've done is all about, you know, star casting and people demanding a refund if the star isn't on. Miriam, who normally plays Juliet, is not on stage, but it's Grace Moat, who I know is one of the original six girls. I'm very excited about that. Got a programme there, nice pink programme, and pink gin. I mean, obviously, if we're seeing a show where all the staff members have got pink shirts on, it's got to be pink gin lemonade. Hope it doesn't get cancelled.
Thank you very much. Apologies. At some point, you will see someone more glamorous and outstanding. We need about another 5 minutes, everyone, so thank you very much for your patience. I promise you now, you're not going to be disappointed. It's one of the best shows in town. But we'll be with you shortly. Thank you. Thank you very much for your patience. It's so appreciated. Please put your hands together for the And Juliet company.
Hello, darlings. Well, I have just come out of the matinee of Anne Juliet, and I'll give a proper review once I'm back in the safety of my own flat and everything, but I just had to get it out of me right now. Oh my goodness, this family next to me during Anne Juliet, the pre-show and the first half, I just could not believe it. I've never had to do this before. This is something I've never had to do in a theatre before. I had to ask at the interval to move seats because this family was bugging me so much. They were up and down, all the time, drinks slurping, talking. And get this right, the mum said to me before the start of the show, oh, I'm going to have to pick up my phone and organise a taxi for my mum about halfway during the first half. And I was like, no. And she was like, oh, it'll only take like 30 seconds. I was like, no, that's not the point here, love. And I have to admit, I did get a bit like, why didn't you sort this out before the show? Because believe it or not, I haven't paid £100 for this ticket and come all the way down to London just so I can sit in a darkened room and be blinded by your phone. I just could not believe it. I've never had that happen to me before. I had to ask the duty manager if I could move to a different seat. They were absolutely fantastic, the staff, but my goodness, I just was just in unbelief of how the audience etiquette. It was insane. Luckily, the second half was much better than the first half. But my days, I just need to get that off because that was quite stressful, to be honest. Oh, okay, now the actual show itself had good points, bad points. I'll give a proper full review soon. But I'm in disbelief at the theatre audience etiquette that I was seeing from some people in the show. It was unbelievable in that particular group of family audience members. And that particular family, they just did my head in. Fair enough, if you need to do all that stuff before the show, that's fine. But once the show starts, love, and the lights go down, I kind of want to be transported into the world of this show. That's what I've paid the money to do. So please, don't be doing things where you're talking to each other all the time and getting your phone out to book a taxi for your mum. Sort it out beforehand. I was just like, I just could not believe it. I was in utter shock by that. Rant over. Now, I'm hoping my experience at Frozen, at least from the audience side, will be better. But I just want to give a quick shout out to Grace Murat, who was absolutely fantastic performing in the role of Juliet this afternoon. So, lovelies, I'm here inside the Theatre Wall Drury Lane, the gorgeous new Theatre Wall Drury Lane, all done up. Got myself some merchandise, had to get like a bag, and I got a t-shirt and a programme and a magnet. There were some beautiful rhinestone water bottles, but £60? I don't have £60 to spare on a rhinestone water bottle. Right, better get in there, because it's so gorgeous, look at all this.
Thank you. here at the moment, so I'm going to go somewhere a bit quieter.
Wait, can you hear that in the background? Someone's blasting out Let It Go. Must be one of those car light things we saw earlier on.
Here he comes!
So hi my darlings, I'm back now at King's Cross Station. Had a very wonderful but very knackering day. I'll give proper reviews coming soon for Anne, Juliet and Frozen. Just wanted to talk a little bit though about the mess that the audience has left behind at Theatre Royal Drury Lane. I'll show you some photos now. I just couldn't believe it. There was glasses and ice cream pots and rubbish everywhere. Like, I get it, it's a family show, so there's going to be more mess, but come on guys, this is an incredible, beautiful theatre that's just been restored so fantastically, and it's so amazing. Why is everyone just leaving their junk all on the seats and everything? Just like, pick up your mess and put it in a bin. It's really not that hard. It does upset me a bit, honestly. Oh, and I thought I saw Cameron McIntosh having a drink in the bar, and I sort of walked on like, la la la, and then went, whoa! But it was not Cameron McIntosh. It was just someone who looks incredibly like Cameron McIntosh. That's very naughty for anyone to look like Cameron McIntosh and be in a theatre who's not Cameron McIntosh. Oh, and I totally forgot to talk about the drama, the tech drama at Anne Juliet. The show started for about the first 2 minutes, and the chap, Oliver Thompson, his name is, who plays Shakespeare, his microphone wasn't working, so they stopped the show. I thought, oh, it'll only be a couple of minutes while they just replace his microphone. It was about 25 minutes, half an hour, before they restarted the show. So I have to admit, that was tense, because I was like, oh, God, is it actually going to happen? Are we going to see this show? Are we going to see it? But like, it all went fine. So thank you so much for watching, my lovies. If you've enjoyed watching this video, don't forget to subscribe below and check out Fabaret on Instagram, TikTok and Twitter and Facebook. Well, bye for now, darlings. Mwah. I'll see you next hashtag this Thursday. Yay!